Hey, Kate, it's Lauren. You haven't been answering, so I thought I'd drop by. I just wanted to let you know. Bye.
Hey, Kate. It's been a while since we last spoke, hasn't it? I hope you haven't forgotten about me. I know writing letters is a little old-fashioned, but sometimes I like to just sit down and write something out, you know? So I can't remember what I was doing at the time, but all this stuff we used to do when we were kids just came rushing back to me all of a sudden the other day. Remember when I'd sneak over at night so we could both go out on our adventures ghost hunting, we called it? We'd shine the flashlight through the trees and jump at every little insignificant noise. Our imaginations were always working in overdrive. I wish I could rewind back to them. Seems like everything after that time just hasn't been as good for the both of us. Sorry, ignore all of that. I started rambling too much. Anyways, please let me hear from you soon. I know things have been less than normal for you lately, so I just wanted to check in. CR. Hey, Kate. Both my computer and phone have been acting weird lately, so I figured I'd do it the old-fashioned way again. glad we could meet up and talk things through. I agree with what the doctor said too. There's an explanation for all this stuff. The shared traumatic events sound the most logical to me. That night out there in the woods is probably what caused it. I had almost completely blocked that out, but now it's kind of coming back to me. But like I said before, it's really foggy. I think the best course of action right now is to just ignore it whenever you think you might be seeing things again. I'll try to do the same. That'll probably do the trick. CR. Yes, you should call Lauren sometime. I bet some company would help out.
again when I saw him today. He really wants you to come in sometime just to talk with him. I think it's a good idea. He also said that confronting this traumatic event in some way could be very beneficial too. Don't worry, I didn't tell him any specifics about what happened. I do think we should go back out to that park behind your mom's house sometime soon. Warning, Coleman Mining. In the event of sudden power loss, all employees must be removed from the mines via the emergency exit door in the main lower corridor. To unlock the high power door, the multiple power fuses found throughout the facility must be manually turned on.
Doing some digging and came across an old plot of land that belonged to the Matheson family a ways back. Charles was known to take his wife Diane and his son Charlie to the old homestead for family picnics. I never imagined what I would see there. I think Charlie may have seen something, something he was never meant to see. Enclosed is a recording of my findings and some documents I came across. We're dealing with something dark here, Kate. Something I can't explain. CR.
My name is C.R. On site, the Matheson farm is said, looking for the missing child, Charlie Matheson Jr. Let's see what we can turn up. Thank you. Okay, after spending some time here, I think I've figured some stuff out. I found a tombstone and this family picture of sorts. Let me show you. Okay, so as you can see here, it gives you all the names of the people in this picture, and one of them is Frida Matheson. Frida Matheson is the person that was buried in the tomb, and from what I read online, a bunch of these houses in this homestead area that belonged to here, the Mathesons, were burned down by her decades ago. This was way back in the 18 or 1900s, and from what I can tell, what I've read, she burned the houses down because of her fatal obsession for finding some kind of mythical creature. Sound familiar? And Charlie Matheson Jr. obviously was in the Matheson bloodline, and none of the Mathesons, apart from just one, Charlie's mom, still live to this day, and most of them were killed in the fire that Frida caused. And the thing that worries me the most, maybe that thing that we saw as kids wasn't actually just our imagination, because everybody who lived here has died because of it and Frida's obsession to it. She killed herself too. She couldn't get rid of it. And another family that lived here. Henry Hayes. His last name is Hayes. That's your last name, Kate. Hayes. This could all be happening to us for a reason. Just don't know what to think of it right now. Gotta get out of here. Please answer your cell phone and wait a second. What the fuck is that? There's more of them.